Hi everybody, and thank you for watching. So here is another Rite Aid haul. So I did go back to Rite Aid to do a few more deals. If you watch my other video, I was doing the spend 30 get 10 on the You Buy Kotex because I did have a bonus cash challenge. For some reason, maybe one of the products wasn't working towards the bonus cash challenge, so I did notice that. So I did go in and pick up two more of the tampons just so I can get to my bonus cash challenge, the tier 3. And we do have a Fetch Rewards bonus with this one as well. And so I do have another Fetch Rewards account with my husband's card and or his phone. And then I did submit those with a few other receipts from CVS, and I was able to get the bonus there as well with the You Buy Kotex. So that worked out to be a really good deal. So I will go over everything, and like I said before, I'm trying to max out all of my bonus cash challenges. That way I will have no bonus cash that's going to expire while I'm on holiday. Don't mind the dog is whining in the background. He really wants to go out and play. I just want to really get this video done beforehand. So like always, I'll go over the breakdown of each of the deals, show you my receipt, and let you know how much I paid. So we, like I said, before all that, we do have that spend 50 get $10 booster coupon. I did mention in my other video that there's three coupons. I went onto Real Deals community tab and she did post a fourth coupon. So there are four coupons that you can utilize to get $10 back for every $50 that you spend. So in my other video, I did do two transactions. I used a circular coupon and the email coupon. And then in this transaction, I did use the web coupon. And so that I've used already three coupons on one card, and then I did do another transaction on my other card and use a circular coupon. So I will show you that. And so let's just go over all the deals. So I did go to a different Rite Aid and I was able to find a few more Revlon. It's sad that the coupon did expire on Saturday, but I was still able to pick these up and it allowed me to get to the $50 mark so I can get that $10 booster. So I did find a few more of these foundations. So we do have a few here. At this store, they were $3.24 each. So I did pick up these four and I did get $3 back each from my Bada. And then I picked up these eyeliners here. So they're all the same. This is a 92 liquid eyeliner. It's a brown or a bronze. And so these ones are also $3.24 each. So I did pick up all of those. So I did pick up eight of them. So eight of them did come to $25.92. I did get $24 back from my Bada, so it worked out to be a cost of $1.92, which I'm more than happy to pay. I'm actually going to pack those up and bring them with me to the Philippines. We are leaving on Friday, and so I have packed up quite a lot of my stockpile, especially a lot of makeup, to give away to family over there. Another deal that I did is the Bounty. So they are on promotion for $7.99 each. These are the 4 = 8 count. So I did pick them up because I do have a bonus cash challenge. So I did hit the tier 2 on this to get $4 back in bonus cash. There is an Ibotta rebate. It doesn't scan. When I scan the barcode for these, it says that it's not a participating item, but when I submitted my receipt on Ibotta for the Revlon, it did pick up the Bounty, so it actually gave me $6 back on Ibotta for that one. It was a glitch. I don't know what happened, but it happened, so I was able to get a bit of a discount there. So basically the Bounty, they're $7.99 each. Two of them came to $15.98. We do have a $1 digital coupon, so that came off, so I paid $14.98. I hit my tier 2 on the bonus cash challenge, so I did get $4 back, or I will get $4 back come March, and I did get $6 back from my Bada. So that was a really surprise there. In the end, I paid $4.98 or $2.49 each, which is a really good deal there. So I did do that. I did do the You Buy Kotex, so I just picked up two of them. So now I've got about 11 tracking. I can go back and do it, max out that deal. I'm not sure if I will. I really have to start packing for Friday. We're leaving really early on Friday. So I don't know if I'll be able to go back to the store and do more deals, but I did pick up the Ubuy Kotex. So two of them. One is, these are the smaller packets, the 16 count. Last time I got the larger packets, the 32 counts, but these ones, they are $5.69 each. So buy one, get one 50% off. They're part of the large promotion, spend 30, get 10. But I just picked up these because of the bonus cash challenge that I have. So one is $5.69, the other one is $2.84. So it came to $8.53. I ended up hitting my tier 3 on the Ubuy Kotex, so I will get a bonus $4 back in bonus cash challenge. And then I did scan this receipt onto Fetch, and even though I did not spend $30, for some reason there's something weird that's happening with Fetch, and it ended up giving me the 5,000 points. In the end, this worked out to be a small little moneymaker, and I didn't have coupons, so I was really happy about that. So I did pick up that one as well. And I think that's about it. That's all that I got on this transaction. So I will show you my receipt really quickly. So over here, you've got there the Revlon. So all of them at $3.24 each. There is the 5 for 25 flu coupon, so I have been using that all the time. There are the two bounties, and there's my $1 load. There's the two Ubuy Kotex. So I spent $44.43. I got $10 back. So I got $10 for the web, spend 50, get 10. And then you can see here with Kimberly Clark, I've got $11 tracking, so I could spend another 19 and get $10. Not sure if I'll do that, but I ended up getting $10 back. So basically with that one, it was $44.43. I got $10 back in bonus cash. I did get $8 back in bonus cash challenge between the Ubuy Kotex and the bounty. And I ended up getting $30 back from my barter, $24 for the Revlon, as well as $6 for the bounty. And then I did get $5 back from Fetch. So in the end, for all of that, it'll work out to be about an $8.57 money maker. So really, really happy with all of that. Was very, very surprised that that worked out to be a money maker. Then I switched cards and I did a few more deals on this other card here. I was, like I said, I was trying to do the bonus cash challenges. And so with this card, I had a bonus cash challenge with the Scuncy. When I spend 13, I get $4 back. There is also a weekly promotion with those ones. When you spend 10, you get 3. So what I did was I went in there trying to spend $13.07. So I got, these clips were $4.79. This little hair tie was $3.39. And then these ones were $4.89. So altogether for all of those three, it did come to $13.07. I did get the $3 back in bonus cash, as well as hitting my tier 3 on my bonus cash challenge. Worked out to be a cost of $6.07, which I'm more than happy to pay. I also had a Clorox bonus cash challenge that if I spend $9, I get $3 back in bonus cash. So I did pick these up. So the wipes, they're on special for $5.99, and then the sprays on special for $3.99. So for the two of those, it did come to $9.98. There is a $1.50 off 2 digital coupon. So I did clip that and that came off. So I paid $8.48. I got the $3 in bonus cash challenge. Worked out to be a cost of $5.48 or $2.74 each, which I'm more than happy to pay. So I did pick that one up. Another deal that I did is the Compeed. So I did pick these up last week. I didn't realize that the buy one get one free is a monthly deal, and so it was still tagged in my store. So I did pick up the Compeed. They are $10.99, buy one get one free. So two of them come to $10.99. We do have $5 coupons from a recent insert, so I did utilize two of those, so paid 99 cents. And then for my barter, there's $2.50 back on each of them. So $2.50 back on the medium and $2.50 back on the mix. So that's $5. I did submit this on my husband's account. And so there is a bonus as well that if you buy two Compeed, you get $1 back. So I got $6 back there. Worked out to be a $5.01 moneymaker for the Compeed. another deal. So just a bonus cash challenge. He had a bonus cash challenge for the bounty, and so I did pick up two of those for $15.98, and then I did hit my tier three, so I got $3 back in bonus cash. So those two work out to be a cost of $12.98. Another item that I did pick up a Downy. So they're on promotion for $5.44. We do have a $1 digital coupon, so I did pay $4.44. I just needed about $4 to hit my tier three on my bonus cash challenge. So this allowed me to get that. So I did get $2 back in bonus cash. So it worked out to be a cost of $2.44. And so that's basically it. Those are all the items that I got on this card. So I will show you my receipt. So over here, you've got, there's the two bounty. I'm not sure why the $1 digital coupon did not come off here. And when I did send this, when I did scan this receipt to my husband's Ibotta, it did not pick up the $3 Ibotta rebate on this one. So I was happy that I got $6 on my other one, but it didn't pick up on here. There is a Clorox for $5.99 with the $1.50 load. The other one is back down here. There is a Downy for $5.44 with the $1 load. And there's the three Scunsies. There is my 5 for $25. There are my two Compeed with the $5. So I paid $37.96. I got 13 back. So I got $10 back for the circular barcode, the spend 50 get 10, and then $3 back for the Scunsie. The Scunsie is a limit too, so I could spend another $7 and get 3, but I don't think I will. I'm just happy that I was able to max out my bonus cash challenge. That way I know that the bonus cash is locked in until March and it's not going to expire. So that's it on that receipt. So with that one, I paid, before all coupons, it was $55.46. So after all coupons, I paid $37.96. I got $13 back in bonus cash. I got $6 back from my barter for the Compeed. And then I also got $12 back in bonus cash challenges between the Scunsies, the Clorox, the Downy, and the Bounty. So I was able to hit my tier 3 on 4 bonus cash challenges. With this card, I think I've hit 9 out of my 10 already. So I'm really, really happy about that. Hopefully when I come back from holidays, there's a deal on, I think I've got bonus cash on the Colgate. So hopefully there's a deal when I get back and I can max out that. And then I've done 10 for 10. So that is one of my goals, to try and get as much as my bonus cash challenges as I can. But in the end, for everything, so I paid $37.96 after coupons, after all the bonus cash, and I bought it, worked out to be a cost of $6.96. So not bad. So one transaction was almost a $9 moneymaker, and the other one was a cost of $7. So basically for all of these, it would have cost me like $106. It worked out to be a $2 moneymaker. So I was really, really happy to pick up all these items. I really have to rearrange my garage. I have so many paper products with all these Bounty and Charmin deals with Rite Aid, as well as with CVS. I've been going crazy with the Scott a few weeks ago. I really need to rearrange because I have so many paper products. I could, to be honest, not pick up paper products for a year and I'll be happy. But I can't say no to some of these amazing deals. I'm basically getting paid to take all these items out the door of the store, and these are products that we use. So we use these Bounty, we use this Downy and Clorox, we use the You Buy Kotex. This is something that my kids will use, and then I'm happy to just pick these freebie makeup and give them away to family. And so that's about it. That is my Rite Aid haul for this week. Like, I honestly, I don't think I'll go back to Rite Aid before the week ends. I'm happy with the 4 transactions that I did and all the bonus cash challenges that I was able to complete before my trip. I did want to also mention that there is this P&G promotion right now that if you spend $50 on select products, you get a virtual gift card or a Visa gift card. And so with all the Bounty here that I did purchase, I am planning to get to, I'm short a little bit to get to the $50 mark, but I do plan to do that promotion, especially with all these Bounty that I've been buying. And so with that one, this would work out to be a huge money maker overall after that one, after that, getting that rebate. But I am not going to count that rebate into this transaction because I haven't hit the $50 in bounty products to then qualify for that. But there is a PNG promotion. So if you are buying the bounties and the Charmans to hit bonus cash challenges, do keep that in mind with the PNG rebate. And so, yeah, here is my Rite Aid haul. Thank you for joining me.